This is Janet and Rabia.
Welcome to Everest Physics Academy.
Before we start, we'd like to recommend our Everest Physics books for high school,
where you can find more explanations and solve applications and the problems.
This episode, we are going to apply the conservation of linear momentum to explain explosions. Apply the conservation of linear momentum to explain collisions. Define the elastic collision. Define the inelastic collision.
Explosion. Explosion, like the explosion of a bomb, the explosion of a firecracker, etc. This video shows the explosion of a firecracker. Explosion takes place during a very short time interval under the action of internal forces between the constituents of the system. If the explosion of a body takes place above the ground, so in this case, we have no normal reaction acting on the body. So what is the consequence of such explosion? During the explosion, the magnitudes of the internal forces between the constituents of the body are much greater than those of the external forces acting on the body, such as its weight or and air resistance. So the weight and air resistance in this case can be neglected relative to the huge internal forces inside the body. So the system can be considered as isolated. So we can apply the principle of conservation of linear momentum. So P system just before the explosion equal to P system right after the explosion.
Now let's move to collisions. Watch this video. The billiard balls collide with each other. In most cases, during a collision between two objects, their velocities are changed during a very short interval of time, between 10 and 200 milliseconds, under the action of the internal impact forces. The internal impact forces acting between the two colliding objects during the collision are often much stronger than any other external forces. Actually, in collisions, the external forces acting on the two colliding objects do not necessarily add up to zero, but they are neglected relative to the internal impact forces. Therefore, the system of the two colliding objects can be considered isolated, and as a result, its linear momentum is conserved during the collision. So we have P system initial is equal to P system final. This is going to be M1V1 plus M2V2, the linear momentum before the collision, is equal to M1V1 prime plus M2V2 prime, the linear momentum after the collision.
Focus, please. This is important.
Elastic collision. What do we mean by elastic collision? Watch the short animation. A ball falls vertically downward from a point A, and then it collides with the ground. Since after collision, the ball returns back to its initial position A, then we can conclude that there is no loss in the kinetic energy of the system ball Earth, or the kinetic energy of this system is conserved during the collision. Therefore, a collision between two objects is said to be elastic if the total kinetic energy of the system two object is conserved during the collision. So we can write the kinetic energy of the system just before collision is equal to the kinetic energy of the system right after the collision. This is going to be 1/2 M1V1 squared, which is the kinetic energy of the first object just before the collision, where M1 is the mass of this object and V1 is its speed before the collision, plus 1/2 M2V2 squared. This term represents the kinetic energy of the second object just before the collision, where M2 is the mass of the second object and V2 is the speed before the collision. Okay, this term is equal to 1/2 M1 V1 prime squared. This term represents the kinetic energy of the first object right after the collision, where V1 prime is the speed of this object right after the collision, plus 1/2 m2 V2 prime squared. This term represents the kinetic energy of the second object right after the collision, where V2 prime is its speed right after the collision. Note, V1 prime and V2 prime do not represent the derivative.
Let's move to the inelastic collision. Watch this ball. Unlike the ball in the previous slide, this ball reaches a shorter height after each collision. As a result, part of its kinetic energy is lost. In most collisions, part of the kinetic energy of the system before the collision is converted during the collision into thermal and other forms of energy. In this case, the collision is said to be non-elastic or inelastic. So, the kinetic energy of the system of the two colliding objects after the collision is less than the kinetic energy of the system before the collision.
Thank you for watching. If you like this video,
subscribe to the channel, hit the like button, and share.